Hey everyone, I'm Anna, an educator at the North Carolina Arboretum. If Ecoexplorer is new to you, well then welcome. Ecoexplorer is a citizen science-based program where kids 5 through 13 years old can take photos of wildlife, earn badges and prizes, and help scientists all at the same time. Once you take a photo of something in nature, you can upload it to your Ecoexplorer account. You can earn 1 point just for submitting a photo and earn additional points for taking an in-focus photo. Labeling the correct ID. Taking it at a hot spot, one of our partnerships with North Carolina parks, libraries, and other nature areas. And submitting photos of wildlife belonging to the current field season. You can put these points toward really cool prizes. And you can sign up at our website, ecoexplorer.net. And now it's time to kick off our next field season, botany season! Botany is the study of plants. We must first ask ourselves a simple question of, what is a plant? Maybe we can answer that question by figuring out what isn't a plant. Come with me. Is this a plant? Of course not, you're right. This is a bobcat, which is a mammal, not a plant. Ooh, how about this guy? Is this a plant? Nope, not a plant either. This is an eastern tiger swallowtail, an insect. Ooh, this one's a toughie. Is a mushroom a plant? Or how about this lichen? Even though, like plants, they stay in one place and don't walk around like us humans, they are still not considered plants. This one has to be a plant, right? Wrong. This is coral. Not a plant either. So, what makes a plant anyways? Well, all of the things I just showed you, mammals, insects, mushrooms, lichen, and coral, cannot be considered plants because of a few important reasons. First of all, for the most part, plants make their own food through a process called photosynthesis. Now, I don't mean make their own food like go to the kitchen and make themselves a sandwich. I mean just by being on this planet, plants take in sunlight through their leaves and turn it into usable energy. Imagine if you could be in the sun and get your food just by standing there. Oof, I'm getting stuffed. What else makes a plant a plant? To find this out, you have to look really close. Here you can see that like every other living thing, plants are made of tiny structures called cells. Plant cells are unique to other types of cells because they are more rigid with stiff cell walls. And check out those green globby things. Those are called chloroplasts, and that's where the magic of photosynthesis happens. It's for these reasons and more that plants are so successful in growing in all types of environments. Look here at this forest. There are plants everywhere, from the towering trees above me to these low-lying shrubs, even the ferns and the moss at my feet. There are plants all over, but plants grow in more places than just forests. Plants also grow in deserts. And in caves, in the ocean. In Antarctica, yes, that's right, even perhaps the harshest climate in the world. It's true that our planet is so amazing and diverse because of plants. For this reason, and because plants are just so darn cool, they've been inspiring scientists for centuries with their amazing abilities. With the new field season comes a new badge to earn, the Botany Badge. To earn this badge, you must take 6 photos of plants, upload them to your Ecoexplorer account, as well as complete 3 out of the 4 challenges listed on our website, ecoexplore.net. Now, what are you waiting for? Get out there! Oh, good luck, have fun, keep exploring.